Remind, вот мы будем вспоминать, о чем мы говорили на прошлом уроке, о настоящем, прошедшем и будущем времени. And этот текст поможет нам вспомнить правила, немножко вспомнить русский. Okay? And we will not listen to this dialogue, just we will read it. Okay? And Ahmed, please, can you start read just this one? Okay?
Okay. Здравствуйте. Здравствуй. Здравствуй, мама. Как у тебя дела? У меня все нормально. Я уже в Москве три дня.
Yes, okay. And next one. And guys, I hope that you understand this meaning. And if you don't understand, just let me know and we will translate. Or what do you think? Should we translate it as it's all to English?
Not for me.
Ahmed, Slavka, and Vitaly, what do you think?
No.
I know, I cannot answer. And Tayet and Ahmed, will be better to translate or you understand this meaning?
Laura, уже, what does it mean? Уже.
Уже, it's yet. Oh, I'm sorry. Already. Уже. Like already in English. Okay, I think we should translate it. It will be better, okay? And Ahmed, please translate what you read, what you read.
Okay, здравствуй. Hello, mama. How are you? I am normal. I'm already in Moscow. 3 days or.
4 or 3 days, I guess.
4 or 3 days.
Okay. Well, and I will skip.
But there is no 4 in Russian.
No.
Something like 4.
No.
Four?
Ah, no. Yes.
Like English, yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
And say, for example, if you are in Moscow, have been in Moscow. Oh no, have been, I think.
I've
Moscow,
already been in Moscow for 3 days.
And if it's 3 years, you will say 3 года. Or if it's 20 years, you will say 20 лет. You don't use prepositions, any preposition in this case. Okay, and Slavka, please read next one, okay?
Okay. Я живу в гостинице «Националь». Это в центре. Сегодня я первый раз работал в офисе. I'm staying in a hotel National. It's in the center. This is my first day in the office.
Yes.
We can't translate literally.
Yes, of course it's a different language and. Yes, I think it's very understandable what you translate, Slavka. Thank you much. Next one, Tayet, please translate. Oh, 1 second.
Okay, help me, Laura. Okay, I will try, but yeah.
We will help you. Don't worry.
Потом из да был в ресторане. Ресторане я и мой русский коллеги обедали там.
В ресторане. Just a little different stress.
Ресторан, restaurant.
В ресторане.
Then I was at the restaurant. Right? Is that right?
Потом you can translate like then.
Then, okay. Then I was at a restaurant, and I Gedali. I ate dinner. I
It's not
Happy
dinner.
Week.
It's there is food. He tells us about lunch, and I think it will be I and my Russian colleagues had lunch there in restaurant. Там it's there,
there.
Means in restaurant. There. Yes, well. And
thank
you. Next one, please. Have you understood that?
Yeah, I understood.
Yes, and let me know if you don't understand. And have me, please, next one.
Okay. Yael, Porsche. Это русский
традиционный. It's like tradition in English, and традиционный it's adjective in Russian.
Традиционный суп. Пельмени. Пельмени.
Пельмени.
Пельмени. Это как раволи.
Равиоли.
Равиоли.
И пил
море.
Морс. It's S.
Yeah, it's better now.
I see it's not maybe not so readable.
Highlighting it's bad. Yeah, okay.
Okay, and translate.
What does it mean, yell?
Second.
Yell. Yael,
yell, it passed of eat. Like in English, I ate.
Okay. So I ate Porsche. This is a Russian traditional Russian soup.
Pelmeni, it's name of dish too. And do you know ravioli, Ahmed?
No.
Ravioli is Italian dish, yeah. And he compares that pelmeni in Russian. This is like Italian ravioli because it's famous too.
And I drank Morse.
Morse. I don't know. Is it in English too, Morse?
I don't know what is this. Try to explain me in Russian. What is this Morse in Russian?
Morse, Slavka, это напиток из ягод.
Only ягод?
Yes.
You mean fruit? Strawberries?
No, usual, yes, it's ягоды. Is ягод.
Strawberry juice.
Oh, yes, like this. It's like juice.
Let me check Google what's this, because I don't know. Morse? No,
Morse.
It's because I'm writing.
It's напиток.
I'll find it.
Just try to remember that it's a напиток, it's a wood drink sometimes. It's from, could be from fruits, it's usually, I don't know, ягоды.
Ah, yes, it is strawberry juice. I can send you pictures from images. But not only strawberry, Laura, the pictures are, it's not strawberry. It's not ягоды. It's some kind of a red berries. I don't know. It can be different. Strawberry, fruit, everything. It's water plus sugar or honey and this fruit.
Yes. I can't. Я не могу сказать, что это популярный напиток в России. Но иногда мы пьем это. Not usual. Okay, and hello, Boniface, привет.
Привет, Лора.
Привет, как дела?
Отлично. Спасибо, а у вас как?
Хорошо, все хорошо. Это join us, присоединяйся к нам. And Boniface, can you read this one? You see what I...
Так, Но я не знаю.
See on see to my screen.
Yeah.
To my screen. And you see in blue.
Yeah, yeah. Это очень
скучно.
Это очень скучно. Вечером я был в театре. Но я не знаю.
Next one. Я думаю.
Я думаю, думаю, что это большой театр. Но я не знаю.
Yes, I think you read it. It's just sometimes your voice is broken.
Yeah.
Okay, and Boniface, say again this one. Вкусно. Вкусно.
No.
Just sometimes I don't hear you. Вкусно. Because you said it like скучно. Yeah. Different.
Yeah,
okay?
Вкусно.
And then вкусно.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Boniface, translate please to English.
Hello?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I hear you now. Oh, Boniface, I think you have problems with sound. Check it, please. Sometimes I don't hear you.
Hello, can you hear me?
Now, yes.
Okay. Это очень вкусно. It is very delicious, yes? Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Вечером... I was in the theater.
Вечером?
In the evening, я был. I was in the theater.
In the evening.
Yeah.
Or tonight, sometimes we said вечером.
Mm-hmm. I think it is a big theater.
Mm-hmm.
No, the names. No. It's большой театр. It's not big театр.
Ah, okay.
The names of the buildings or institutions cannot be translated.
Mm-hmm. It's a famous большой театр. It's famous in all world. People who are interested in who is interested in theater knows
yes.
that. And maybe you heard in Slavka. Have you heard about большой театр?
Of course. Don't understand
me. I'm Bulgarian. Yes, it's very famous. Well, and the next one and last one, Boniface, please.
But I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, and I see. See the message from Rifam. Of course, and I think it's difficult for you. Of course, it's more higher level, and I wish you will study with the beginning, and I can advise you then the programs. Okay?
Okay. Thank you very much.
Nice to see
Bye-bye.
You. Goodbye. До свидания, Даш.
Goodbye. I went to the start the P6 first. Okay, bye-bye.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Rima, you can say in Russian goodbye, it's до свидания. Ah, she is gone. Okay, and we will continue. And Slavka, please, can you read this one?
Там я смотрел балет. Очень интересно. I watched ballet at the theater. I watched ballet. It was very interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and type, please, last one.
Okay. As teachers, I очень устал Now I'm very very what, Laura, tired?
I'm very tired, of course, yes. Очень устал. Устал, it's tired. And if I will say, я очень устала. And in this sentence, we understand that man or guy told us. It's not woman or girl, because устал, not устала. Mm-hmm. And the last phrase, type this.
До свидания, мама. Bye-bye, mama. Goodbye, mama.
Goodbye. Okay, and now this is a short test about this. And first question for you, Ahmed. Пожалуйста, ответь на этот первый вопрос. Read and choose the answer. Читай и выбирай ответ.
Работает в Москве. Yes, да.
Okay, we'll choose. Yes. And next one, please, Bonifaz. Bonifaz, I don't hear you. Mute
hello.
Yourself. Now I hear.
Он живет в гостинице Национал.
Okay, see here.
Да.
Okay, да. And Slavka, please, next one.
Да. Он обедал в кафе? Нет, он обедал в ресторане.
Yes, exactly, well. And type, please, next one.
Сегодня он big mox, maybe да.
Yes, it's exactly, not maybe, это точно да, он big mox. Yes, well. And Ahmed, please, next one. Good question, we discussed it. Мы обсуждали это. Ahmed, I don't hear you. Maybe you're muted.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Морс, нет, это ватка и кук. И сук.
Сок.
Сок.
Сок, it's juice.
Juice.
What do you think? Что ты думаешь?
Yeah, это сок.
And what is, это да или нет? Какой ответ?
I don't understand what.
Морс это водка. I will морс. It is without alcohol. And there is water.
Yes, нет, нет.
See? Нет, of course нет. Okay. And next, Boniface, please.
Борщ это.
I don't hear you again.
Hello.
Now I hear.
Борщ это вкусно. Да.
Да. Не сомневаюсь. Да.
Конечно, да.
Слив.
Очень.
In Ukraine.
Да.
And he knows. Ukrainian, Russian, yes, usually yeah. To Russia from Ukrainian. It's famous borscht. Okay, and hello, Camille, Camille Caraca, or Simile Caraca, new student joined us. Oh, shy and to go. Okay, and next, please, Slavka.
Его коллеги говорят по-русски. I guess yes. No.
Yes, of course, because
of course they're Russian.
Was Russian. Russian colleagues, okay. And the type?
Пимени это ravioli barbrowski. I don't understand, Nora, can you?
Pelmeni is the name of dish, and ravioli, is it similar Italian dish? And I can say that it's da. Pelmeni, it's in Russian, and ravioli, it's in Italian.
No, Laura, the name of the traditional dishes cannot be translated. Pelmeni is pelmeni, and you can just explain that it's small dough pieces and blah, 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 blah. But it's pelmeni, it's not ravioli.
No, they say maybe this meaning like that it's like similar, it explains because you don't know about pelmeni, and he explained to his mother that, but in this sentence, one second, pelmeni это ravioli по-русски, maybe he means that pelmeni, he tries explaining it, maybe. I don't know if we can check if we're right or no. Okay, and Tai, choose your answer.
I don't have any clue. So.
Okay, we will choose. I think it's not so important. Da or no. Again, we will choose no. Okay, and next, Ahmed, please.
John Bill Vichrom via theater. Via театр. Да.
Окей, and Boniface, next one. Boniface, I don't hear you. Check your mic.
Да. Джон Бир.
I don't hear you again. Oh, has you have some troubles with sound? And I will...
John, hello.
Yes, now I hear. Я слышу, Бонифас, продолжай, пожалуйста.
John Bill, и слышал там концерт.
Is it true? Это правда?
Нет.
Нет, of course. Was in the theater. Okay, and Slavka, next one, please.
У него есть кабинет в офисе. We не знаем.
Да, мы не знаем.
Нет. Я сегодня работал в офисе, ничего не сказано. Я думаю, да.
Okay, we will choose.
Yeah, what does it mean, у него?
У него, it's has. He has in English.
Private room, office. Or maybe he has his own office.
У него, it's like, it's difficult to explain because у него, it's like pronouns. It's on, and у него... It's coming from on. If I will speak about Slavka, I will say у неё. It means she has. У. It's like, I don't know how, I think we will study it later, okay?
So this is not, negative or?
No,
it's very positive.
У него?
It's pronoun.
У него?
This не, него.
У него... У неё, у них, it's plural, они, у них, он, у него, она, у неё, it's a pronoun, yes.
Okay.
It's difficult to understand now, but try to remember and then we will study. Okay. Oh, from tired, the sound.
Oops.
Okay, да. Or no,
it's not him or her in English, but with different usage.
He has, yes.
Oh, no, it's not him or her in English.
Just in Russian we use Yes, it's a different way. And now you see, we read this text, and there we use many verbs, for example, and to be, to я живу, it's I live, and работал, it past of, it's worked, past of работать. And now what I advise, just practice, and work, and I will open method. We see it, and then we will practice it. And see, for example, to work. And Ahmed, can you read past form of work, to work?
Okay. On работал, она работала.
Работала. Sí.
Работала. О,
uh-huh. Работала.
Они работали. Оно работало.
Работала. Окей. Okay. And Boniface? Mm. Yeah, yes, very well. And everything is right. And Boniface, please, next one. It's, as you see, present tense.
No. Я работаю. Ты работаешь. Она работает, мы работаем, вы работаете, они работают.
Окей. And next, Славка, please.
Я буду работать, ты будешь работать, он, она будет работать, мы будем работать, вы будете работать, они будут работать.
Mm-hmm, okay, it was future, это было будущее время, future, будущее время in Russian, and present, настоящее время, past, прошедшее время. And I see the message from Tait, and Slavka, Boniface, Ahmed, do you hear me well?
Yes.
What about the sound?
Yes,
yeah, it's okay, yes. Now, it's okay now.
Well. Because I use mic from laptop and maybe, I don't know, maybe something wrong. Okay. And guys, what I advise you now, short exercise. For example, we will start with Ahmed. Ahmed will tell us what he did yesterday, what he is doing today, and what will he do tomorrow. Just choose the word, it's verb, should be verb, of course. If you don't know meaning, I will help you. Okay, and then I will ask Boniface something else. Okay, Ahmed, please start.
Okay.
And I will help you if you need to translate something.
Yeah, how to study, изучаю, or?
Mm-hmm. And firstly, past tense. Изучать, it's study. Изучать.
Изучать, okay. So, mm-hmm. вечера я изучал.
Mm-hmm.
И сегодня я работаю.
Mm-hmm.
И завтра я буду работать.
Ага, yes, very well. And Boniface, please tell us about Ahmed, what he told us. Okay? Just you speak about Ahmed. For example, Ahmed did something yesterday, he is doing this today, and what about tomorrow? Okay?
Ahmed изучал. Сегодня mm-hmm. он работает.
Mm-hmm.
Завтра он будет работать.
Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly. No one mistake. Ни одной ошибки. Очень хорошо, Boniface. And please tell us about you.
Вчера я гулял. Сегодня я изучаю, завтра
Я буду
Буду, and Boniface, we didn't hear what you said. Завтра я буду.
Я буду смотреть фильм.
Yes, well. And Slavka, please, your turn. Твоя очередь. Tell us firstly what said Boniface.
Okay. Вчера он гулял, сегодня он работает, and завтра он будет смотреть фильм.
Yes, well. And please tell us about you. Расскажи о себе.
Okay. Вчера я спала. Не помню. Спала. Смотрела фильм. Читала. Я не помню. Сегодня я приготовила... What is this in Russian? Homemade jar. Jam, sorry. Oh.
Ah, jam, the same in Russian. It is the same, jam.
Сегодня я... but it was in the morning. Утром я приготовила... я сделала домашний джем. Завтра я буду работать в школе.
Yes, well. And Ty, please. Tell us about Slavka.
Я забыла, что...
Мы не активны.
I'm sorry, Тай.
Да.
I will try. Вчера она работала. Сегодня она работает. Завтра она будет работать.
So hard worked, Славка. Always, всегда работает. Okay. Well, and how will you say that? I don't doubt, Slavka, я не сомневаюсь. And that, how will you say, if Slavka watched film in the morning, for example?
In the morning? Утром. Утром она смотрела телевизор.
Yes, exactly. Very well, guys. You have good level. And Tide, please tell us about yourself, okay?
Okay. Вчера я играла. Играла what? Играла шахматы. Is it okay?
Шахматы.
Yeah.
Very well.
Сегодня я... Oh, I don't have new words, Laura.
And I can't help you, just say in English.
Сегодня I stay at home. So, я дома.
But please start use the verb, okay? You can say that you rest today.
Today? Сегодня я была, right?
Where? Где?
Дома.
Дома. Сегодня я была дома.
It's not, okay. It's not an activity.
It's to be. Yes, it's to be. But if you didn't say...
It's not an activity.
You can say отдыхать, it's infinitive, just кречь, one second, I will отдыхать, oh, so many mistakes. How will I'm resting today, or I have rest, отдыхать in Russian. To have rest.
So which tense do we use in this case, or a past tense or a present tense? Okay.
Now see, you said about past tense. Now say about present tense. Said.
Present tense. Okay. Сегодня я отдыхаю.
Exactly. Отдыхаю.
Я вот я буду буду работать.
Работать. Okay. Работать. Well. Yes, it's это правильно. Ахмед, расскажи, пожалуйста, о Тает. Что она делала, что она делает и что она будет делать?
Вечера она. I would ask about the first verb she used. I didn't get it. What does it mean?
And Tayet, can you say again Tayet. What you?
Вечера.
Can you ask Tayet in Russian? What did she do yesterday? In Russian, please. Okay, try.
Тает, что ты дела?
Делала.
Делала. How? Делала. Что ты делала вечера, Тает?
Yeah. Вчера я играл шахматы.
What does it mean?
Играла шахматы.
Шахматы. One second. I write infinitive form in the chat. It means играть в шахматы. Ахмед, it means play chess or chess.
Play chess. Play chess.
Ah, play chess.
Играть is play. Okay.
And Тает, she, она играла.
Вечера она играла в шахматы.
Шахматы.
Сегодня она. I don't remember.
At the cup.
Сегодня она отдыхает. Отдыхает дома.
Yeah.
Завтра она будет работать.
Yes, exactly. Well. And I'm surprised that no one mistake. Everyone said very well without mistakes. And I see Nikolai Gaspar join us. Hello, Nikolai.
Hello, thanks a lot, my friends. I'm Nikolai from Romania, but for me it's the first time here and I don't know Russian language. I want to learn, just.
You said you are from Romania or Armenia?
Yes. Romania.
Ah, Romania. And I see your language is totally different from Russian, I guess.
Yes, yes, but I know Cyrillic character. I learn it single. I learn it single. Cyrillic.
On his own.
Singer?
No!
He studied Russian on his own.
Ah, yes, sorry. It's a single, just with yourself.
Yes, yes, yes.
You mean that?
Yes.
Yes. And join our classes every Sunday. We have regular class, and you can see the Russian dances today and practice and join. Really nice to see you in class. Okay. And did you study before Russian, as I understood? Yes, a little bit.
Yes, yes.
Thanks. You can read, I guess. You can understand elementary, maybe more.
Yes.
And guys, what I think we should, we have just 10 minutes, and maybe we will practice more, and we will use previous exercises, and we studied it much time ago, and again we will train, because I think it's very important to speak about and change the verbs, past, прошедшее время, настоящее время, будущее время. Okay? And Boniface, please, can you say, can you add here? Я работаю. First, how will you say you work?
Ты работаешь.
And one second. Next, please. One second. It's work. Работаешь. Well, and next, please, Николай, how will you say she, he or she works?
It's hard for me because I don't learn Russian language.
Work. Okay, and
она работная.
Он работает.
Работает. Sorry.
We speak about мы говорим о настоящем времени. It's present tense. Он, она работает. Okay. And Slavka, next one, please.
Мы работаем.
Работаем. Exactly. And Tayet, please.
Вы работаете.
Работаете. Yes. And last one, Ahmed, please.
Они работаем.
No.
Работают. Работают.
Работают, yes.
Работают.
And yes, very well. And see, in general rules in Russian, two groups, and the first group, the end, you see, ends with ать, ять. For example, работать, отдыхать. Many, but maybe somebody can say example. Работать, отдыхать with ать and ять. Представлять. So it's like imagine. Okay, and it's first group you see here with A, and the second group with no A, it's yet and it. And for present, you should know just how you divide these verbs and these two rules, and then you can change every verb, and we'll speak correctly. Okay, I think we can practice a little bit. One second, and this is Russian verbs. We will skip it. Oh, this program is a bit crazy again. But we will practice. Okay, and now. We will start with Ahmed. Ahmed, please read and see. We speak about present tense and change. Okay?
Okay. Вот мой друг Джон Смит. Он из Англии. Он студент. Он не работает.
Он не работает, yes. Okay, and Boniface, next one. Второе предложение. Я не слышу тебя, Boniface. Check your mic, проверь твой микрофон.
Это моя сестра. Ее зовут Светлана. Сейчас она читает журнал.
Читает. Well, and Boniface, how she will read?
Она будет читать.
And she read it yesterday?
Она читала.
Читала, yes, very well. And Slavka, please read next one.
Это мои родители. Они хорошо говорят по-итальянски.
And in future and in the past, please, okay?
Они говорили, они будут говорить.
Yes, very well. And next one, please, Tait.
I'm Andrei Vrach. Я не знаю.
Yes, exactly, я не знаю. And how you say, I didn't know?
Я не знала.
Okay, and in future, but not negative.
In future?
I will know, we say.
Я буду знать.
Yes, я буду знать. You don't change verb, it's infinitive. Just change I will, it's like я буду. Okay, very well. And next, Ahmed, please, номер 5.
Извините, сколько сейчас времени? Извините, но я не понимаю, что вы говорите.
Okay. And how say I didn't understand?
Но я не понимал.
Не понимать, если не понимал and не понял. I haven't understood, не понял, я не понимал. Yes, a little bit different. Okay, and in future?
Я не буду понимать.
Я буду понимать. It sounds a little bit strange. I will understand. I think in English it's too a little bit strange, but in Russian we can say it will be the same meaning like I will understand. You can say in Russian "Я пойму." It's the same about future, but without will, without буду. Я пойму. Yes, it's a little bit strange, but if I say "Я пойму," it means I will understand too. Okay, and next one, Boniface, please. And number 6. Следующий.
Вы говорите по-русски.
We don't hear you again, Boniface.
Чуть-чуть.
Do you know what does чуть-чуть mean?
A little.
A little. And how will you say говорите, говорить in past and in future?
Говорили.
If you speak only about yourself.
Okay. Говорил. Буду говорить.
And if you speak in past about Slavka, that they spoke, how will they?
Sorry, please, I didn't understand.
They, Slavka and Tait spoke before.
Они говорили.
Yes, exactly, well. And Slavka, please, номер 7, пожалуйста.
Что вы делаете? Мы слушаем радио.
Слушаем. And if we do it yesterday,
слушали. Будем слушать.
Yes. Слушай. Okay. And last one, please diet.
Ты зна ишь? Владимира. Да, я его знаю.
Знаешь. Okay, and if you ask about past, and for example, if you ask Slavka, did she know Vladimir? How will you ask that?
Can you repeat again, Lauren?
And ask Slavka about Vladimir. Did you know Vladimir? Just in Russian.
Ты знала? Ты знала Владимира?
Ты знала Владимира? Да, это правильно. And say about you that I will know Владимир.
Я буду знать Владимира.
Я буду знать, but actually in Russian it sounds strange too, because but now we just practice like technical grammatically, we will use it and it's correct. Okay, and guys, it is all for today. Thank you for joining, and the next class.